Are we live? Yeah, it worked. Okay. Cool. Sorry, I had something set up for it differently to see if the game would record properly, so I have to put in my stream key again. And I thought maybe I got the numbers mixed up, but no, I did it right. My stream key is K12345678910. And I thought maybe I messed it up, but no, I got it right. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Let's get the game started so we can have some music. Booby Souls? It is Booby Souls, you're right. It is very much Booby Souls. Anime Booby Souls. Do. Spooky stream, very spooky. So the boys are being very bad today, so you may hear some shouting. One of the boys may have to go to their room. Our punishment that we use for the boys is if they misbehave, they go have a timeout in the room. Usually no more than about, say, 10-15 minutes. So that might have to happen because they're misbehaving quite a lot today. So we'll see. I might have to mute the stream or pause the stream at some point because they are misbehaving so much today. So sorry about that. They've also been brawling a bit. They've been at each other's throats a little bit lately. Oh, wow, that's loud. All right, Code Vein. Here we go. Ugh. So, very Dark Souls-y kind of title screen, but also with music kind of like Nier Automata, I thought. It's kind of like a mix of Nier Automata meets Dark Souls. So. Oh no. Okay, so pressing any key. Alright, so I'm gonna play offline because I don't know what the online features are and I don't like having to play with other people. I don't want any ashen stuff happening. So my settings are as follows. Game settings, I turned attack auto tracking off. I played it for a little bit on my own. And I just made sure that it worked properly. I skipped all the cutscenes. I don't know anything about the story. I also skipped the tutorial just to run around the first area, so we'll be going through the tutorial. I turned attack auto-tracking off because I just don't like that, and everything else I'm keeping on. Brightness settings are like this. I always find that these lie to you, and you, like, please adjust the brightness so that only the image on the left is visible. That's usually lies. Like, you have to turn it up way higher than that for having an acceptable experience, IMO. I feel like games never get this right, so we're just going to leave it on that one. Graphics are on these settings. Everything's pretty much cranked apart from frame rate cap. I had some issues with frame rate, but I think we'll be okay. It wasn't until I turned VSync on that they resolved themselves. I don't know why, because I'm pretty sure the refresh rate of this monitor is higher than 60, but I don't know why, but yeah, that's it. And I think that's all we can see. Stereo. Is there a subtitles thing? I think subtitles were there no matter what. Maybe language settings. Event subtitles. Yeah, there we go. Spoken. All right, there we go. Okay, we're good. Okay, so let's go to new. And there's something that this game does that's really special. Oh no, why is analytics lowercase on the menu? I know, it bothers me. Oh, by the way, I don't know if it's going to show up, but the mouse cursor keeps showing up on my screen. Hey. Think back. Search your memory for an image of yourself. How is the sound compared to me? I did some tests and I thought this was the best, but if you want me to turn up a little bit, that's meant to be a little quiet, so maybe it'll be fine. The voice is a bit quiet, it's a bit low. Okay, I'll turn it up a little bit, but not too much, because I had it on 11, minus 11 decibels, and it was a little too loud, so I'll turn it up to 12. Okay, there we go. And we just learned that we can alt tab out. That's nice. All right, so remember appearance first. Okay, female, of course. Okay, so welcome to the game. This is the game, and then there's a like Souls-like mini game after this. But this is the game. So you can customize your character, and there are all these presets, and they are pretty good. And we have some quite extensive options when it comes to tweaking this. So we're gonna start with this one. And we're going to go to advanced settings, and we can see that we have physique, and we can zoom out and we can see the physique. And if we go from the side, because that, you know what, let's change the clothes first. So clothing down here, we can change to something that will show this a little bit more. So let's go with this one. This is the basic t-shirt and little skirt, and we can go to physique, and I wonder what this does. And you know, it just kind of affects the whole body, but mostly certain areas more than others. So there we go. And if we see it from this side, you know, so you can tweak your physique, and yeah, so there we go. So obviously we're going to crank this all the way up to 20, and you can change the skin color. Found that the skin color options were a bit lacking. There was no crazy colors, but maybe you can change the hue and option setting that I missed. But what I really like about the character creation thing here is that you can press R2 and it will change the lighting, and it will show you what your character will look like in different lighting throughout the game. And I really like that. If you ever made a character in Skyrim and then you get past the first area, you get inside the first little dungeon, and you look at your character and you're like, what the hell? It doesn't look like anything I thought it was going to. So this is pretty cool. There's also different poses that you can see, and she'll move. And there's the other pose, and we can do different expressions. She's smiling now, she's like really interested about what we're doing, and now she's being a little mischievous. What a little minx. And then we have the basic expression. Okay, I don't really know what camera POV does, so go figure that out. And let's go through the more of the options. So we have a lot of hairstyles. Lots and lots and lots of hairstyles. And we have different face styles. You can change the eyes. The eyes are really cool too. So you can zoom in really close to the eyes, and you can see the difference here with the different kind of... I don't know what they are. I don't know what that would be. Anime eyes. Lots and lots and lots and lots of options. It's pretty cool. Then you can change, you know, the color of the background, which has a name for it that I can never remember. And then you can even do the anime lighting things as well. Change the eyebrows, but, you know, most of them are about the same. You can put some makeup on. You can give her some scars. Face paint. And accessories. Now, accessories are actually quite extensive. There's a lot of accessories. Hats. Little hats. Headphones. Someone has bought this game during this little showcase here. I'm not even kidding. Someone has bought this game. I haven't watched this. And like, that's it. This is for me. So you can put some glasses on. You can put the Kill Bill nurse eye patch on. Weird sunglasses. Kind of like a blindfold. The rose. Necklaces and stuff. But what's really weird is that you can also... I don't know if this is the best one to show it. So you can select it, and then you can go to advanced editing, and you can change where it is. So now it's on the back of her head. Now it's on the side. Now it's here. Now it's down here. And then you can like move it around too. So if you want her to have hats for nipples, you can do that. It's really, really strange. Let's give her a crown for a nipple. And you can like make it, you can make them bigger too. You can make them smaller. If you want really small crown nipples, there you go. And yeah, it's weird. It's quite advanced for what you can do. Give her gloves, you can give her collars, and the collars that are on the arms can also go on her neck. So there are ones that just start off on her neck, like here, but these ones on her arm, you can then go and you can change it around her body, and it'll grow in size. And then you can put her over her head if you want. I don't know why you'd want to. and then it can go on her neck, and then you can edit it, and it's quite extensive. What else is here? There's little bows, there's some feathers, there's some wings, and I don't know what these are. Oh, these are like fish jewelry. Okay. Anyway, so you can also change the clothing. So the clothing you can change to on like a individual basis. Like you can take some of it away. But I find the clothing options are quite limited. So there's only these ones that you can use. And, you know, there's not really that much you can do with it. Anyway, so here's one I prepared earlier. So load appearance. You can also save it, and we're gonna load appearance. Oh, let's go look at the masks too. So the masks are for when you are outside, I think. For whatever reason, your character can't breathe in some of the stuff, so you need a different kind of mask. And you have mask frame as well. I don't really know what that's all about. And you can change the voice.
I think we have to give up for that was fun.
Okay, so here's some I prepared earlier. So here's Joker from Persona 5. Here he is. Say hello to Waffles. We made him, okay? However, that's not all I made, all right? So here, we're gonna zoom in real close. And I've made three, and there's another one too, all right? So here's Joker. Here's someone. Here's someone else. And down here we have the mystery waifu. And that's all you're going to see the mystery waifu for now. Okay, so this is the best I could get to be. All right? This is the best I could. All right? Not the best work, but it's the closest I could get to be. All right? Had to mess around with two different types of blindfolds to make 2B. I got the feathers on her gloves. So the thing you have to understand is that there's a budget for accessories. So see the cost down in the bottom. You can't add anything else. You have to be within that cost. I don't know if you can go one over. I didn't do any testing or anything anyway. But yeah. So we did that. However, I made another one. So prepare yourself, chat. Prepare yourself, chat. And then we're going to do a vote. All right. So who's this? Who's this? Do 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 do. So this is the best I could make her, okay? And I found someone else made this, and I took some like stuff from that to figure this out. This isn't all me, okay? I don't want to pass this off as my own work, okay? So this is what I had some like online Google search help to make this, okay? Anyway, so these are our choices, chat. So we can either play the game as Waffles Datapon, Junko Inoshima, 2B, or, and I'll show you guys it again close up, just a flash again, so be ready, okay? Be ready. We're going all the way down here. We're going all the way down. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's it. We're not seeing any more. All right, that is the mystery waifu, and I want to be clear on this, of my own design. All right, that's not a character. That's my own a waifu of my own design. All right, that's the mystery waifu. Okay, so we're gonna do a vote, and here we go. You guys get to vote for what we play as. Poll new, who should we pick? Joker, Junko, 2B, Mystery Waifu. All right, here we go. I'm gonna spam it in chat. Spamming it like crazy, there you go. You vote while I say thank you to subs and bits and everything. And we'll see who wins. What's coming? All right, we're not gonna listen to the whole thing. All right, so there we go. I don't know who's winning yet. I haven't checked, but here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Anyway, so while you guys vote, and I'll spam it in chat a couple more times. I'll spam it in chat a few more times. All right. Thank you to Bartiox and Jissy Joshi, Seferiox, and Justin T1118 for subbing while the stream was down and resubbing. Thank you very much. Hopefully you're here, or you can resub again and there'll be a message. Thank you, Hyros, for the 23-month resub 15 minutes ago, right when the stream started. Thank you very much, Hyros. Thank you, Jewel Emma, for the 6-month resub. Thank you very much, Jewel Emma, or Julie Emma. I think it's Jewel Emma. Every single time I'm going to say that, every single time. Thank you, Blobfish2000, for resubscribing for 23 months with thank you, Mr. Gamer Man for Games. I'm curious, who's winning? Who's winning? Oh, Mystery Waifu by a landslide! By a landslide, Mystery Waifu! Wow! Wow, there's no coming back from this. I'm gonna spam a little bit more just in case. But Mystery Waifu has won, huh? Hmm. Was that the right choice, chat? I don't know. We'll see. Thank you to Daxtier. I'm having so much fun. Daxtier for the 813 sub with the message Time Flies. Thank you very much, Time Flies. Thank you very much, Daxtier. Time does fly. No kidding. God, the years are just rolling by now. Thank you very much. Thank you, Twisted Tootsie, for the 15-month resub with the message Booby Souls. It is Booby Souls. Yep. It is Booby Souls. Is it Shrek? It's not Shrek. It actually is a waifu, okay? It actually is a waifu. But we'll see. We'll see. There's tension right now. There's tension. Thank you to Forlorn Winter for the 19-month resub. Thank you very much. Thank you, Devil58, for the 19-month resub as well. Thank you very much. Both 19. 19 months. And let's reveal the waifu. Let's reveal the waifu. Okay, here we go. Let's do it. And then I'll resume saying thank you. We're revealing the waifu. Okay? Here we go. This is the waifu, okay? This is the magical cat girl waifu. Magical cat girl, angel devil, magical princess waifu. Here we go. This is what you chose, chat. This is what you chose. Do you like her eyes? They're different colors. Do you like her butterfly tattoo? She has a I hate this. Played like a damn fiddle. Yep. Played like a damn fiddle, man. Played like a damn fiddle. We demand a people's vote. It's real bad. Yep, it is. Not disappointed at all. Oh, man. All right, so I'm not going to make you guys sit and watch this for a whole playthrough. So we will do another vote, and this time you actually can. Just in case you were here, you missed it. Here are the other characters. So we have Joker from Persona 5. Joker from Persona 5. Junko from Danganronpa. Only Danganronpa won, though. 2B. And then we have Bubblegum cat girl demon princess angel. I'm so proud of this. I'm so proud. Lily helped. This isn't just me. Lily helped. Our goal was to make her as trashy as possible while also being passable as some really dumb waifu. The butterfly and the face paint was all me. All me. Lily chose the wings. I specifically lowered her tail. Like, specific... I specifically lowered it, you know, instead of it being up there. Anyway, so I'm not going to make you guys sit and watch this train wreck for the whole thing. But if you vote for it, we will. But we'll do another vote. Here we go. We'll do another vote. A real one this time. All new. For real this time. Okay, poll new, for real this time, Joker, Junko, 2B, Catgirl, Angel, Princess. Alright, here you go. The Catgirl will get even more votes this time. Well, at least you guys are making an informed, mean decision instead of falling for my trap. Alright, here you go. Here you go. There it is. There it is. The choices, again, in case you missed them, are Bubblegum, Catgirl, Angel, 2B, Junko, and Joker. There you go. Enjoy chat. I'm going to say thank you to everyone now. Oh. Thank you to Malevis for the 17-month resub, Yusuke voice. Hey, Joe, I'm going to celebrate 1 year early to save money, Jake. JK, really glad the streams are back. I find it really easy to fall asleep while watching your streams, and I didn't want to rewatch the Danganronpa streams for a third time. Third time? Use the Danganronpa streams for a sleep aid? Holy crap, that's hardcore. Well, I'm glad that you're enjoying them, Alevis. Thank you very much for the resub. Thank you, Bohozu, for the 24-month resub with a smiley face. Welcome to the 2-year club, Bohozu. Softlump has graciously made some updated chat icons for more than 2 years, but I don't think anyone's there yet. No one would have them yet, so I'm going to get them uploaded. I also need to update the bottom below the stream. We have quite a few contributed artists that need to have credit down the bottom, and I'd also like to fix up some of the discrepancies down there too. So hopefully you like the 2-year chat icon. Thank you, Dragon555, for the 23-month resub. Do you know how to say sup dog in Japanese? Konnichi Chihuahua. Who's winning the poll? Catgirl, Angel, Princess still won? What? You guys made an informed mean decision. 2B number 2? Holy shit, I thought for sure Joker would take it when it was an informed decision. Here we go, here's again. Here we go, we're doing it again. Revenge, hey, I'm happy to play as Catgirl, Angel, Princess. That's, you know? That's my anime baby, alright? Oh, it's so much fun. So much fun. Here it is, by the way. Here's Catgirl, Angel, Princess. Oh, man. Thank you to the Seraph of Chaos, appropriate name for this game. Thank you very much for the new Super Prime. Welcome to Primetime, Seraph of Chaos. I feel like I've said your name before. Maybe there was another Seraph that we had. Welcome to the Waifu Warehouse. Thank you, Soulskin23, for the 12-month resub. Hey, Joe, welcome to the 1-year club, Soulskin23. Hey, right back at you. Hope you're doing well. Thank you, Galuth, for the 24-month resub. 2 years already. Welcome to the 2-year club, Galuth. 2 years in the Cringe Cafe. Thank you very much. Time flies. Thank you, Colorplant, with a U. Every single time, thank you very much for the 8-month resub. Good to see you. Thank you, Red Zeph, for the 9-month resub. Hey, Anders Pouts. 9 months now. Can't give up on this channel since I've had so many good times with you in chat, so I'll be subbed forever. Oh, that's really nice of you to say, Red Zeph. I hope you enjoy it. You're enjoying today's cringy-ass memes with the character creator. Wow, there are a lot of people that subbed right now. Holy crap. Okay, I might have to get through it a little faster so we can start the game. Holy crap, I thought I was near the end, but I'm not. Thank you, Girl Scout, for the 6-month resub. Thank you very much, Girl Scout. Or some say Girl Scout. Thank you, Lesser Capybara. I hope I'm saying that right. Capybara, for the new Super Prime. Welcome to Primetime. Welcome to the Weeboo Wagon. Thank you, Anton69, for 100 bits. So how many hours did you spend in character editor, Joseph? I think I spent about 45 minutes making them all. Lily helped at the end. Yeah, I was having a lot of fun setting up for the stream joke. I've been looking forward to it all morning. Thank you, Nyarlathotep. Hopefully I'm somewhere close for the 24-month resub. 2 years already. Holy shit. Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's... I don't know how many times I've said your name wrong. But it's flying by. It's flown by, yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mercologist, for gifting us up to Lily. Already in the waifu warehouse. Thank you, Mercologist. Welcome, Lily. Here's a claw fist. Thank you, Groot Zia... Zia Zderskwise? Oh my god. Groot Zia Zderskwise. That's probably 20% correct. There we go. For 8-month resub, 8 months down, the rest of eternity to go. Thank you very much. That's an uplifting message. Thank you, Eddie Obscure. Eddie Obscure, maybe? Eddie Obscure. Ah, there we go. We did it. Took three tries. Welcome to Primetime. Thank you very much for the new sub, Prime. Same to you, Velrad. Welcome to Primetime. Thank you very much for the new sub, Velrad. And I'm almost at the end, I think. No. It's still scrolling. So let's get into the game, and then I'll resume saying thank you. But let's double check to make sure that Catgirl Angel Princess won. Oh, 2B almost took him out. 100 off. All right, we're Catgirl Angel Princess. Here we go. Does chat want me to make any alterations to her before we start? Because this is now your waifu, chat. Show 2B one last time. Here you go. Here's 2B. So how I did it was I found someone who else who had made 2B, and I kind of based a little bit off of that. However, I did one better than they did by putting there are two different types of blindfolds. One's the big one here, and the other one is an individual one. So what I did was I took an individual one, like a small one, and I turned it and made it smaller so she has the extra one on the bottom. And it actually took me quite a while. Change everything. I'm pretty sure you can get 2B's hair in this. I didn't see 2B's hair. Is there a better hair that's 2B's? Is it this one, maybe? Is that 2B's hair more than this one? That one? Is that more 2B's hair? It looked like her head grew. Like, look at the top of the hair, right? And it's like it's higher. So I don't really like it. So I just went with this one. That was more A2. Bigger boot first, not noticeable. That's unfortunately the only way it can go. I don't think we can make that bigger. Because it's part of her clothing. And you can't increase it, so that's it. So here we go. Like for more garish, too subtle at the moment. Move her pupils to the top of the eyes. Do you also want me to open her mouth? Yeah? Okay, like that for the whole game? For the whole game like this? Or should I turn it back? Alright, that's it. That's it for the whole game. You guys made it worse. Alright, here we go. Here we go. We're confirming. She spends like most of the game with a mask on, I think. So, alright, here we go. Go back. All right, what's her name? What's her name, chat? What's her name? She can't be Waffles Dadapon. What's her name? Waifu Becky? Catherine? Reload for two. Waifu Joe. Bacon Fever. Sapphire Pegasus. I kind of like that one. Okay, we're going Waifu Joe. Waifu Joe. Alright, there we go. We made Waifu Joe. Alright. Damn. Lot of decorative options here. Alright, there we go. We're Waifu Joe. Condensed milk. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh shit. Alright, we're done. This is it. That's what you look like. Now we can finally meet. Alright, here we are. Oh, she's wearing clothes. How do we take them off? I don't think we can. Okay, so I'm playing on a DualShock 4, not an Xbox controller, because it just seems right. When you think of Weeb games, you think of PlayStation, right? So we're using a DualShock 4. Circle is roll, and square is attack. And you can chain attacks. There seems to be some sort of stamina that isn't being displayed to us right now, and I think I remember that from when I played it a little bit. Triangle is heavy attack. X does nothing right now. I think X is probably confirm. L1 is guard. L2 is parry. R1 does nothing. R2 does nothing right now. And it doesn't seem like there's a run. If you hold down circle after dodging, there's no... Yeah, there's nothing. Rest at missile. Skip tutorial. No, we're not going to skip the tutorial. Alright, so I did skip it when I played before, but only to... Oh my god, this is just a disaster. Oh shit, she looks so ridiculous. Okay, let's go.
Each revenant has a different power coursing through their veins, called a blood code.
Blood code, okay.
The best way to learn about it is to try it for yourself.
Open field menu. Revenants possess special powers known as blood codes. Depending on the specific blood code, a revenant's stats will differ. To view these stats, select the currently equipped blood code on the menu screen. Okay, so options. Okay, so is that it? Fighter? That's our blood code? Code owner unknown, boasts endurance for melee combat. Okay.
Each talent that a blood code bestows is known as a gift. The fighter blood code grants ever increasing endurance. It seems you also have a gift that temporarily enhances your attack power. Try it out.
Try equipping adrenaline. Revenants are capable of using unique techniques such as gifts. Which gifts can be used depends on the revenant's blood code. Passive gifts grant constant effects. Simply by being equipped, while active gifts must be used to grant their effects. So it's kind of like a ring slot, but not really. All right, so it's a gift quick slot. All right, so what's this one? Restorative offering, triple annihilator. All right, wow, the baby's really upset. Adrenaline temporarily boosts attack power. Iker, or is it Iker? I think it's Iker, right? Iker costs 5, cooldown 5 seconds, strength B. All right.
Give it a try.
Very well. Iker and gifts have been reset. It's Ikor? 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 Iker? Mario? R2 hold plus square X, triangle circle, left, down, up, right. What? Oh, okay. All right. Not in order. Okay. All right. So. The Lost.
You can drain Ikor from the Lost by striking the
Ikor. Okay.
Remember that. Those are the basics of a fighter's gifts. Use and learn each of them well.
I love that we have a tail. Lock onto enemy in sight, weak attack, strong attack, dodge, guard, switch weapon. What's our other weapon? All right, we have a big hammer and we have a sword. I like the sword. Okay, so I'm guessing Ikor is kind of sort of like Hollow Knight. You attack a monster and you get some. Oh, it's not on every hit though. It's in the bottom right. Okay, can we parry? No. Can we parry now? No. Oh, okay, so you have to time the swing of the parry into the attack. It's not an instant parry. Okay, so it's kind of like Dark Souls. All right. That wasn't a joke, actually. That was me saying it's kind of like Dark Souls. Oh, fucking hell. Okay, let's go.
Well done. Ordinarily, a revenant has only one blood code, but you are different.
It's too quiet? Okay, I can turn it up. Ranger code owner. Okay, let me turn up a little bit. It's kind of quiet right now, but it's a little louder later, I think. This code excels at providing support and defense buffs with gifts. You no longer meet stat requirements or something.
Seems to be too heavy for you. Rangers are nimble and best at fighting with light weaponry. Try switching to a bayonet.
Okay. Bayonet. A mass-produced bayonet provided to Revenants in Operation Queenslayer.
That's much better, isn't it?
Much better, okay.
Oh, firing your bayonet requires Ikor as well. That and gifts means Ikor always seems scared. That is where the Blood Veil you have equipped comes in.
Blood Veil?
Using your blood veil will let you quickly drain Ikor from the lost. In addition, this can increase the amount of Ikor you can hold. If you have a chance to drain Ikor from a foe, use it.
Hold X, R1 plus X equals combo drain. Oh wow, now we're up to 18. What? How high does that go? Oh shit, we have to like really fully charge it. Now we're up to 20. All right, R1 plus X equals combo drain. No, don't. In fact, I can't even do that. All right, so if I hit and then R1? No, I don't know what that means, but that's fine. All right, so this is... Okay, and can we fire it? Cool, and that uses an Ikor bullet. All right. Ah, okay, so square, square. Okay, what if I square, square, X does nothing? Square, square, R1. Okay, cool. Can I hold it down the whole time? Whoa, what the fuck was that? Alright, so R1 and square. Okay, so R1 is a modifier on your attacks. Oh my god, her eyes still looking up. Alright, so what about... Cool, alright, nice. Alright, this is okay so far.
That sums up the Ranger blood code and drain. Let us try one more blood code. Now, turn your gaze inward.
I literally can't. I always look at the sky. Specialized and powerful attack type gifts can be used from a distance. Alright, caster.
Possess powers like magic from a fairy tale. With it, you can use gifts to fire projectiles of blood.
Bloodshot. R2 hold. Special lock on your target when using an offensive gift. Alright, so R2, and then we use this one.
You learn quickly.
Alright.
Bloodshot Javer's range over power. Let's see. Try learning another gift. You can learn gifts by touching missiles. Try it yourself.
Rest near missile. Okay, acquire. Can be learned. Blazing Roar, Weapon Drain rating up, Dark Impulse, Bloodshot. Increases the effects of dark gifts while you are focused. Shoots an intense flame at the target. Alright, that seems like the one to get. Alright. Alright, thank you, Hideo Kojima, and a gas mask. Alright, you discovered a gifts latent potential. Okay.
wasn't hard, was it? Now since you've learned it, why not try it out? Gift that punishes foes. However, its cost in Ichor is high, so be careful that you use it at the right time. In addition, its power will change according to the blood veil you equip.
Blood veil.
Blood veils have different affinities for gifts. It can be complicated, but keep it in mind.
Okay. I'll try to. I'll probably forget. Lock onto Aiming Sight. Fighting raises your proficiency with any gifts you have equipped. Once you reach maximum proficiency with the gift, you have mastered it and are able to equip it even after changing blood codes. Oh, it's like jobs! In Final Fantasy, gifts do, however, have stat requirements. Even gifts you have mastered cannot be used if you do not meet their stat requirements. Okay, cool, that's interesting. Why are we not playing as Waffles Dad Upon? Because of chat. All because of chat. Oh, wow.
It's all quite sudden, but you picked it up, right?
I know this is sudden.
The disappearance of your blood code has left you with unique, limitless capabilities. Not only can you change blood codes, but you can acquire new ones.
Oh, we get to keep all these three? We get to choose?
Become your own. A talent that you alone possess. Since you are the only one who can do this, your blood is the only teacher you have. Now, awaken and save the world.
Revenant transformation, revenants were created. Oh, okay, we can't. All right, cool. All right, so I skipped this last time and I just ran around the city. I also skipped the tutorial, so that was all new to me. Is this anime? No. Well. Oh, please show our character in cutscenes. Oh, please. I want nothing else.
Hello. How are you feeling?
Hungry. Yes! Wow. Sometimes a character might be looking up at something and we'll never know.
Don't worry. It's okay. I don't remember either.
Our character fits in. It's not that ridiculous next to her. What is this bandaged nurse waifu? What the fuck is this? She needs a proper name, our character. Chat, collectively you need to think of it's dry. Oh yeah, we need to think of a proper name for her.
We can go slowly. I am here with you.
Okay, so I don't think I can move any faster than this right now.
Just a bit farther.
Okay, am I really off base here? But I kind of feel like in Japanese games, there's this ruined urban setting a lot, like post-apocalyptic, but also in major cities setting. Is that a thing? Am I off base there? I feel like I see that quite a bit in Japanese games and some other media too, from what I see. Like in E3 and stuff. Probably because of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Maybe, but don't know, I'm not that familiar with Japanese media. It seems like a more recent thing.
It seems everyone, everywhere, is thirsty.
Oh yeah, that's true. Especially in chat.
There is a spring that will cure that thirst. One that weeps tears of blood. That's what they said, anyway. This way. It's all right. It's all right.
Oh, man. We're juicy. Like an apple. You see, you know, we're kind of, I'm assuming we're vampires. Like, everyone in the game is a vampire. Code Vein, there's a lot of blood stuff. I'm assuming this, it's something to do with vampires. Could be wrong.
So, it is you. Here, this is for you.
Bit of a slow start, huh? God, I love the butterfly tattoo so much.
A new spring and a fresh source of labor. We really hit the jackpot. Get up. It's time for a bit of fun.
Cold Revenant. Uh-oh. I don't want to mess with her, man. Blood beads.
You're awake then? Whoa, keep it down. Your friend just fell asleep.
Okay, now we stand out. The wings are so bright.
Let her sleep. She wore herself out watching over you.
Sophisticated Revenant.
So, what happened to your masks? Forgotten about those too, have you?
Where's the crestfallen Revenant?
The view never improves, does it? He came back home after the war against the Queen and found this mist. Getting close to it causes enough pain to drive you mad, so no one has ever crossed it. There's nowhere to go home to, even out.
Acquired mass. Okay, the wings are actually a little hard to look at. We might have to go with another character unless we get used to it. I'm actually a little put off by the wings. Let's see what happens.
This one's dry. The miasma's pretty thick. Damn it! We're running out of time before the next collection.
Everything's ready.
Right.
Arrogant Revenant. Oh, now it's better.
All dried up, just like the others.
Yeah, all dried up. So there's no sense in searching with the miasma like this.
Humble Revenant's thrall.
You know what these are, right?
Blood beads, right?
Right?
Yes, very good. Now I want you to search for blood beads in the tunnels ahead of here. You see, it's only a short time before the collectors come to take our levy. But once they do, I'm afraid we won't have any blood beads to give them. If we don't find some, Silva's hounds will strip the shirts right off our backs.
Oh, it's like a Bug's Life. Okay.
Well, that's the long and short of it.
Why does it have to be us?
We're the ants.
Don't ask me. The stupid levy system was Silva's idea. If you have a complaint, I suggest you take it up with him.
You lot go first. Get to work.
Don't. There's a better time and place. For now, we just have to obey.
Good nature, Revenant.
Next!
Whoa there. You wait here with us.
Is her mask
you
broken?
You can have this one back when you return. In exchange for any blood beads you find, of course. Oh, and I hear the Hunter has been showing up around here lately. So make sure you don't all get killed.
We were fine without the mask a second ago. Why do we have to have the mask on now?
Youch.
Youch.
Hey, you okay? It looks like we can't get back up from here. We'll have to look for another way back. Oh, I'm Oliver Collins, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Hey, I'm Waifujio. No. Okay, the wings are much better right now. It must have been something about that scene. We were close up or something, or it was too dark down there. All right, I think we're okay. When you need rest in your missile, your HP and regeneration uses are restored along with your I-Core. However, your I-Core stock limit will return to normal if it's been increased by gifts. You can also acquire gifts containing your blood codes with selecting and hanging. Okay, whatever. All right.
If that ladder was down, we could get up.
Wifles? Aw, oh, that's pretty good, actually. Alright, so I think I want to be a fighter. I don't think I want to be a caster or a ranger. I think I want to be a fighter. So, health boost, increase maximum HP, adrenaline, triple annihilator, unleash a combo on a nearby target, and defensive skill performed with two-handed sword hammer. Okay, I think I want health boost because it's passive. Max out proficiency. We cannot get it. We can. We just have to hit triangle. You can use haze and certain materials to max out your proficiency with gifts, unlocking the ability to inherit them. Doing so enables you to use them even with different blood code. Okay, no, these ones I already have. I already have these. Because if I can max out proficiency, I can use it with something else, right? What are these ones? Defeat the... increases maximum stamina. Alright, so can I max out, unlock? You don't have enough haze. Okay. Level up. Alright, we can't level up. Storage. Oh no, that doesn't bode well. Start tutorial. I thought we were already in the tutorial. Save and return to the title screen. Okay, so what weapons do we have now? We had all these fancy ones before. Okay, can we just change them just in the middle of just walking around? Oh, damn. Huh, that's flexible. All right, so we have a pipe of thraldom, a simple weapon that consists of a metal pipe with a drain function, and hammer of thraldom. It is just a haft with a heavy concrete block at the top, being given minimum treatment to make it a weapon for revenants. All right. Oh wow, they weren't kidding. Okay, I didn't see this weapon when I played before. Okay, I don't like that weapon. I like this weapon.
I guess it won't open.
Doesn't have from this side. Okay, so I need to take a few minutes and say thank you to people before I get behind on it. So very sorry that we're up to such a slow start, but if I don't do it, I'm gonna die because I'm Canadian. So. I have a lot of people on my list to say thank you for. So if you don't care about that, you might want to take a little break and then we'll come back and we'll try the combat out. But yeah, I apologize. Do we want to have a Waifu Joe up in the camera? Can we take the mask off? I'm annoyed I spent so much time and I can't take the clothes off. God damn it. I haven't said that since I was 16. Come on, take it off. If anyone knows how to take the clothes off, let me know. Alright, so thank you to... Action Cater for 100 bits. This is so weird, even for you. I love it, chat loves it, but my Lord Joe, lol. okay. There was a set goal, okay? To be as ridiculous but almost passable at the same time. And I think we nailed it, okay? We fucking nailed it. Thank you, Prince of Puddles, for the 7-3 sub. Thank you very much, Prince of Puddles. This is like almost 40 minutes ago, some of these, so sorry about that. Thank you, Mr. Silverstrike, for the 4-3 sub. 2 months in a row, but 4 total, and that's what we go for. We go for total, not in a row. Thank you very much, Mr. Silverstrike. Thank you, Megawatt, for the new sub. Welcome to the not-so-secret Weeaboo Society today. Usually it's the secret Weeaboo Society, but it's not secret at all today. Thank you very much, Megawatt. Welcome. We'll see if there's a resub at all. Thank you, Zerkzik, for the 3-month resub. Thank you very much, Zerkzik.
What's the matter?
You're encouraging this. I hope that you feel proud. Thank you, Alice6, for the new sub as well. Welcome to kawaii comrades. There we go. That's a weeaboo one. It's all weeaboo today, as opposed to any other day. Thank you, Alice6. Thank you, Enyo, for the 6-month resub. Thank you very much. Thank you, K Roniverse, for the 13-month resub. Your artistic vision truly knows no bounds, Dadapon. Yusuke. Thank you very much, K Roniverse. Sometimes I can tell halfway through that it's a Yusuke comment. I tried. I hope I succeeded. Kawaii, Hawaii. Thank you, Trap, for the 23-month resub. Thank you very much. An early welcome to the 2-year club, Trap. Thank you very much. Thank you, Raikan890, for the 5-month resub with Ayaya. I still don't know what that is. A-Y-A-Y-A. I don't know what that is, but. Thank you, Raikan. I'm sure chat is spamming it already. Yep, there it is. Thank you, Amagat, for the new sub with Prime. I don't know what I is. Thank you, Amagat. Welcome to Prime Time. Thank you very much. Thank you, Action Cater, for another 100 bits. This is after the reveal. You've lost your mind. Oh, that was before. Oh, man. This is from a while ago. Oh, shit. Thank you, Snailer Slug, for the 3-month resub. Thank you very much, Snailer Slug. Thank you, Howdy Duddy, for the new sub of Prime. Welcome to Prime Time, Howdy Duddy. Thank you, Jaden Juiceman, for the new sub of Prime as well. That's an interesting name, Jaden Juiceman. Thank you, Snake131, for the new sub. Welcome to the... Oh, man. The Konnichiwa crew? I don't know. The Waifu Warehouse? Thank you, Snake131. We need new Weeaboo ones. Thank you, Stay... Stay DePeached? One of those. For... The 2-month resub of the message code vein, Waifu Maker, definitely masterpiece. I have to admit, I am impressed with the, I'm not saying that out loud, Ghostly Sun, but holy shit. I am impressed with the character creator. It's quite extensive. Thank you, Snake131, also for gifting a sub to Croc Says Rar. Interesting name. Welcome, Croc Says Rar, and thank you very much, Snake131. Ghostly Sun, you should be ashamed. Thank you, Jason Kim, for the 21-month resub. Questioning putting chat in the videos for YouTube now. Thank you, Jason Kim, for the 21-month resub. Thank you, N-Hunter, for the 17-month resub. Waifu Josephine is amazing. Waifu Josephine, I hope Marek makes some amazing, not safe for work fan art of her. Also, holy shit, she 17 months. Don't put that evil on Marek, man. Like, this isn't even a meme to make it happen, okay? Like there have been jokes about that in the past, but, like, don't put that evil on Marek, alright? Marek doesn't deserve that evil. I'm not even kidding. This isn't a joke. Not a meme. Marek doesn't deserve that evil at all. This is my evil, okay? And then spread to all of you, but don't put that evil on Marek. Thank you, Zire91, for the 9-month threesome. Thank you, Worth Zire. Hope you're enjoying this this train wreck. Thank you, Mr. Smarticus, for the 12-month resub. Welcome to the 1-year club with the message, oh boy, anime souls. Yes, it is. It's hard to tell, though, from the character that we made. Thank you, R. Romanovich, yeah, R. Romanovich, for the new Super Prime. Welcome to Prime Time. Hopefully I got your name somewhat close. Thank you, Chendizi, for the 21-month resub, anime and Dark Souls. This is cheating. Dark Souls is kind of anime, right? It inspired that Berserk thing, so I think Dark Souls gets to be anime just because it led to that creation of that thing that everyone loves so much. Thank you, Chendizi. Thank you. I think there's 4 more left. 1, 2, 3. Oh, 6 more left. Thank you, Carisco, for the new Super Prime. Welcome to Prime Time, Carisco. I think I'm saying that right. Thank you, Rocket Shuttle, as well, for the new Super with Prime. Oh, chat. Thank you, Rocket Shuttle. Welcome to Prime Time. Thank you to Team UN. We win today. We won. Chat fell for the bait, hook, line, and sinker. Thank you, Team UN, for the 513 sub. Hey, Joe, I'm a game dev in my free time. I usually find your videos to be an interesting perspective on games, even if I don't always agree with them. It's just a nice, wholesome, serious message in the middle. while this character is on the screen. Oh my god. Oh shit. Well, I'm happy you get something out of the videos. If a game dev can get anything out of the videos, it's I usually consider it to be an accident. I'm happy that you can get something out of them. And yeah, absolutely don't. Yeah, if you can disagree with them, you get something out of it, that's even better. Thank you very much, Team Ewan, and all the best with making your game. Thank you, Alespeed, or Alespeed. I think it's Alespeed 3 though for the new sub of Prime. Welcome, Alespeed 3. Thank you, Croxy, or Crox, for the 8-month resub. There are so many today. What's going on? Thank you, Croxy. Crox? I just keep saying names. Hopefully, I get them right. Thank you, The Wazoo, for the 8-month resub. Love you, Joe. You the man. Again, I feel like the character is looking at me on the screen. Oh, shit. Thank you, The Wazoo. Thank you. And the last two, last but not least on the list is Amaror 2. Amaror 2, yep, that's it, for 10-month resub. I see you're a man of culture. The cat ears really top the whole thing off. You know what? It's actually a hairband with ears underneath, but I specifically lowered it so you can't see the hairband because that's what needed to happen. And the glowing ears matching the glowing wings, that's all Lily there. So Lily was inspired too. Thank you, Amaror 2. And last on the list, Philip Senna. Thank you very much for the 14-month resub. Thank you very much. Thank you, Philip. And let's play the game.
A dead lost.
Whose fault did Halo? Mine.
I've seen one before. I say dead, but they're not really dead. It's just a dormant state before they turn into
Lost Shard S. Okay.
So I've heard. Sometimes it takes years for the transformation to start.
Back attack. Oh, man. So there's a mini-map in the top right, and we can't see anything on it. If it looks like we're in darkness right now, but it shows a trail of where we've been, which is interesting. What's this one? Restorative offering. Okay. Okay, do you think we can make that? I'm gonna say no.
I feel dizzy.
Okay, so what do we have on our other one here? What's this down here? This is Ichor Concentrate, which is probably just we just get more Ichor, and this is Regeneration. Okay, so do they come back when we whoa, why are we what? Why are we like this? Okay, that's weird. Alright, so if we use this, now we're back to full. Why are we, like, dashing instead of rolling? And do we rest or they come back? Yeah, they do. Okay, cool.
Did you just see movement?
Oh, I love this so much. I'm having so much fun. I'm having so much fun. Even with the parry.
I'm blown away.
Oh, oh fucking hell. If we just walked a little further in, we would have seen it. Okay, are you not gonna go away until I use you? Oh, we can close it. I'm blind. Alright, there we go. Sorry.
Is there something good in there?
Heavy axe. Each piece of equipment has stat requirements, and weight exceeding your weight limits restricts your ability to dodge attacks. Not meeting the stat requirements greatly decreases your attack power. Equipment can be changed from the menu screen. Both the main weapon and the sub weapon can be equipped. These weapons can be switched without opening the menu. Okay, so here we go. So we can switch between these two. Okay, cool. All right, so let's put that axe on. That seems like it's fun. Oh, it's a bit heavy. Oh, and now we're rolling. Okay, so if we take away this... Oh, do I have to have two weapons on? What if I don't want to? Oh, that's a bit shit. Hmm. All right, so let's put that one on that one then. So I have to have two weapons on. Okay. Which way do you think is better? Oh, it doesn't matter. It's all about which one you have equipped. All right, cool. All right, let's go with the fast weapon. Retrieving haze. You lose any haze in your possession when you die. This lost haze can be reclaimed by returning to the location where you died, but only the haze that you possess at the moment of your death can be collected. If you die again before collecting it, the uncollected haze will be lost forever. Okay, so it's like a bloodstain. Okay. A lot of boxes. These look breakable. Yeah. Oh, we fucked up the parry. Okay, so I'm parrying a little too late. Yeah, still a little too late. So it's when the attack starts coming. Oh, he interrupted it. What if we do this? Focus state, your focus gauge fills as you get hit or dodge enemy attacks. Once it is full, your stamina will replenish and you'll enter focus state. You'll become harder to stagger and can more easily stagger enemies. You also gain the ability to knock enemies into the air and perform a drain attack on one. R1 plus triangle is launch attack, but once you're fully focused, I'm guessing. Okay. Okay, that seemed like I did it, so... Did he interrupt the parry? Oh, we're dead. Okay, I don't like you, Oliver. Can you fuck off? Lost bayonet. Okay, so we're out of stamina. Stamina seems really low. Is the bayonet more damage than even this pipe? Physical 44. Oh, it's way better. Okay, so I was really supposed to switch over to the to these weapons then. Okay, so let's switch over to the bayonet. Can we? Oh, we roll with the bayonet. Ah, it's fine. We can still use it. Makes sense that these weapons suck. Thank you, Bugle, for the 213 sub with UWU. Huh, that's weird. Is this some kind of code for Chad or something?
Yeah, I'm fine, really.
Queen Iron.
That wasn't very convincing, was it?
Oliver, you're a beast, don't worry.
These masks are the old type. Hard to breathe in them. How are you doing? That girl, she's your friend, right? We should find some blood beads and go back for her quick.
Okay, so parrying is independent of anything. Of the weapon we're wielding. Oh, what the fuck are you? Oh, someone showed this enemy on Discord. It's the weird Pokemon enemy.
Lost up above.
Okay, that's kind of weird. I'm going back. Sorry. Yellow book, geisha noodles. Bloodstained steak. Used to cause your body to disperse. Not considered upon use, but all haze will be lost. Okay, so that's a homeward bone. Needle of Unity transports you to a location near the Revenant. If you are cooperating, okay, that's a multiplayer thing. Fragment of haze. Okay, so those are souls. Queen iron. An item whose value varies wildly depending on who holds it, and an item whose value. Okay. Awake MJ. What? Special mineral. An activator used to awaken dormant abilities in a blood code. Huh, okay. Mapping. During the exploration, when you purify the miasma in the area, you will be able to map your surrounding. You can purify miasma by active a missile. Purify a rotten missile. Defeat the lost and infected with a rotten inside. With a rotten missile. Sorry, I just completely didn't read that right. All right. So this isn't a bonfire. This is just a Ubisoft tower. Or a Ubisoft flower.
Is there something good in there?
Blue hounds. Gifts and drain attacks power differ depending on the blood veil you equip. Blood veils also affect stat scaling and drain ratings. For example, using Blazing Roar with a blood veil possessing high dark gift. Okay, whatever. Let's go. So we just unlocked the shortcut, so we're back at the missile now. Awesome. Alright. Cool. Okay, so what was that? Like a new outfit? Yes! Oh, yes, we're back. How God made her. Nice. All right. Okay, I need some honesty from chat right now, okay? Mostly anonymous, okay? Mostly anonymous. Does anyone actually find her hot? There are some yeses. There are some. Thank you, appropriate Instaboner, for the 4-month resub. Thank you very much, Instaboner. Oh, God. Thank you very much. And also, thank you again, Bugle. I only said thank you once, and I did the ooh joke. All right, we should probably rest at the missile, right? To get our healing back. Maybe we can also upgrade something. So you do all these soul videos, but nothing on Sekiro? We'll do a video on Sekiro after Witcher's done, yeah. I'm mostly done on it already, but I have to do Witcher. Waifu female. All right, so we should probably just level up, right? Let's level up once. The haze invigorates your body cells, increasing your combat abilities. Nice. All right, so can we acquire or inherit? I would really like to get the stamina boost. All right, so we need Awake, MJ, and 280. You do not have enough materials. What do you mean? Oh, do we need three? Okay, I misread the thing. Okay, we need three. We only have one. Okay, cool. All right. Tutorials, information about the controls and everything. Yeah, okay. Really heavy on the tutorials. You can just hit X and skip them, though.
This is so cramped. We're at a disadvantage.
Ooh, what?
Wow.
Oh? Ooh? That was just a parry. Is that because I put a new shirt on? That's because of my blood veil? Oh, what the fuck? Okay, so in case you don't understand what the difference is, so if I put this on, this is what that ability looks like. This is the same ability. All right, it's a claw that grabs. And I put this on, and suddenly it's like the darkness snakes. Oh, we hit a threshold. Great, okay.
Oh, didn't they pass us earlier?
I'm telling you, man, my character fits in. Well,
okay?
Chat's character.
Hurt?
Oh, they've gone hollow. Oh no, Oliver's deed? Wait.
That could have gone better.
Oh.
I'll catch up with you in a bit. Don't worry about me. I'll be alright. Go on. You just focus on finding some blood beads, all right? That girl is waiting for you. Don't worry about me. I'll be all right. Go on.
Nice. Okay. Now we're solo. Nice. Okay, I don't think there's any way we can go down there, but why was this here? What was he guarding? Seems strange. Thank you, Badger Ops, for the 11-month resub. Thank you very much. Thank you. Early welcome to the 1 year. Catch you next time, too. Thank you very much, Badger Ops. Okay, so hold on. Is the parry timing different now? This seems way faster. Yeah, it's faster, I think. You know what? It's hard to tell. God damn. Some fancy animations. What? I did it. I was behind the enemy and I pressed square to do a back attack. What? Oh, that worked. Okay. Yeah, this is definitely Dark Souls. Definitely Dark Souls. Really strong. Huh. Alright, if you use all your abilities, you are, like, wicked powerful. Huh. Okay. But it's still early on. And the same for Dark Souls, obviously, but you have to kind of build up to the power and getting used to having it all and, you know, getting some spells and everything. But, like, wow, right out of the gate here, you are wicked powerful. Can I just hold this until they get close to me? Your clothes are weapons. Oh shit. Trying to hold it for as long as possible there to see if I can if it ever runs out. But I guess we don't have to do that in front of an enemy. We can just do it anywhere, right? Let's see. Holding it, not letting go. Damn. All right, cool. So like quite powerful. It uses almost all your stamina though. Dagger. Lost broadsword and lost bardiche, a polearm. All right, so let's see. So now we have a sword. I usually like to use swords in games like this. Oh, R1 is run. Oh shit, okay, I'm an idiot. Okay, so R1 is run and also someone in chat is about to say it. Finally! Alright, so R1 is run. Oh god, that's weird, isn't it? R1 being run? But it's also a modifier on your attacks. Okay, Okay, it actually kind of makes sense now I think about it, because if the face buttons are attacks, you either want run to be a face button and your attacks to be shoulder buttons, so you can do both at the same time, or you want run to be a shoulder button and the face buttons to be attacks. That actually makes a lot of sense. Okay, cool. Nice. I take it back. Okay, so now we can get the stamina one. Come on. What's the worst that can happen? Alright, so now we're at the 31. How high can this go? Shit. I think we're gonna die, chat. I'm trying to min-max my bullshit. Can we hold down attacks to make them supercharged? Holding down square? No. Holding down triangle? Yes. Interesting. Okay. Wait, it looks like there's an item here. Oh, it's up there. Okay. Thirty-two. 33. Okay, so even if you don't have enough stamina to do the full thing, as long as you have some stamina, it'll still let you do it. Alright, good. I like it when games do that. Lost Bayonet. Regen Extension Factor. Okay, what do those do? Medicine that permanently increases the number of times regeneration can be used. Okay, so how do I use that? Do I just use it? I'd feel like there's no reason not to. Alright, cool. God, it's 2 out of the 36 of the things that we're never gonna use. Uh-oh. Epic music has started. Look, they look like Mux, right? Am I thinking of the right Pokemon? Or is there a different one now? Is Muk an evolution of something else? I like that the footsteps are getting smaller the further we get along. Grimer. Items that exceed your inventory capacity have been sent to storage. Regen Inducer. Medicine created through Revenant Research causes the body to regenerate. Okay, so these are life gems. So we also have life gems from the looks of it. So these are Estus, regeneration, and then Regen Inducer are life gems or blood vials. Okay. A classic throwing weapon, chemical light, glows dimly in the solution. Okay, we're fine. All right, let's keep going. Sounds like the start of a near song without vocals. Yeah, I feel like the music is very, very near Automata. I'm not going to say near in general because I've only played Automata, like the scrub that I am, sorry. Level up, you can level up and spending. Okay, so this is another missile, damn. Local pennant. Let's level up. Movement looks slow. Well, I'm not running around because I've forgotten already how to do it. So can I get stamina boost? Spoil spotter, learn. I want passive ones because I feel like I'm only ever going to be using the fighter tree. So let's just go with the, let's go see if we can get some passives from these other ones. Increases the effects of, yeah, not really. Increases the drain rating of weapon attacks. Eh, okay, probably good. Can be learned. Focus light stamina usage. Reduces stamina spent while you are focused. Okay, I don't even know what happens when we are focused. Is that when the screen goes weird? Temporarily creates a barrier around you and your partner that boosts blood resistance. All right, don't know what that is. So I'm going to go with getting stamina boost, which I think we can now max out the proficiency of. Nice. So now we have this. All right, so let's... Does it go over here, or do we just activate it over here, or what? Is it that we... Let's level up. We're level 4, chat. Nice. Serious impressions, Joe. What do you think? It seems competent. It's a lot more competent than I thought it was going to be. I remember seeing the trailers and thinking that the combat looked really floaty and janky, and there wasn't any real response to the hits when you hit an enemy. And... there is definitely that. That could be better still, but it's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. So right now, if I was going to pick between this and the Surge 2, I'd probably continue playing the Surge 2. But I think that this is better than I thought it was going to be. All right, so can I equip Gift Quick Slot? So... Okay, I'm probably being dumb. Passives, here we go. All right, there we go. So they're on the other side. All right, so passives are on the left, and rights are active, which we're not really using them all that much. What does restorative offering do again? You can't spend your own HP to restore the HP of companions. Okay, cool. All right. What's with the outfit? This is just the... Okay, sorry, if you came here late, this is just the basic character. This is one of the, like, the first preset that you get when you make the game. It's just... Like, we just skip through and just hit the first template, and this is what it is. Gray face. Thank you, V Red V, for the 1213 sub. 1 year, baby. Welcome to the 1 year club, V Red V. Welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for a full year of subs. Thank you. Hope you're well. Who are you?
Are you a fellow explorer? It appears you're alone. I'm on my own at the moment too, but I was hoping for a partner for the path ahead.
No.
What do you say? Would you mind working together? At least until we're through here? Don't worry, I'm not gonna stab you in the back. The miasma and the lost here are enough trouble as it is.
Damn, is it really a preset? The devs have trashy tastes and awful designs. All right, I want to say no, but it's really early on, and this might be a character that's in the game from now on after this. So let's go yes for now.
I'm glad to work with you.
Thanks for messaging me. Okay, will you come over here and help me fight the big guy? Because the big guy looks scary. Or as our character would say, scary. Ooh-hoo.
Watch your step. Something we can use.
All right, so he's guarding a chest. I don't know if I got that parry off. I think I did, but maybe he... Oh, we have a new blood veil. Queen Slayer Thorn. It covers our masterpiece. All right, what does it look like? So this one is a scorpion tail instead of our cat tail. Oh, that's really cool, but I prefer this one. That's really cool. I like that. Nice. So visually, the game is quite impressive. I'm not talking about graphical fidelity. I'm talking about like style and options and stuff and creativity. I have no idea about fidelity. That's not my area. Okay, so this is a ladder. That looks like a boss. So let's go down here. Can we run and jump? No. Oh, it's here again. All right, so there's a ladder and another path. Okay. Okay, is Stranger like super powerful, or does leveling up really matter? Because I feel like I'm doing way more damage now. Oh, you're just one of those big... Okay, you're moving really weirdly, dude. Are you just one of those big guys that was sleeping? All right. And our bae caught you. Nope, can't parry that, or we fucked up the timing. Uh-oh. Thank you, Lily. Okay, so that was just scrambling the whole time there. That was pretty bad. Not the game on my part. That was pretty bad. I got really low and was just kind of scrambling to heal and then constantly trying to get a parry off between those, not knowing what to do. I did notice, however, that when our health gets low, our wings turn pink, and I think that's adorable. So that wasn't a total loss because we got to learn that. I'm on my way. I would have missed that. Not sure how I feel about items you can find being on the minimap. It kind of ruins the sense of exploration. I can't believe her voice fits her. Oh yeah, we Lily and I looked at all 10 of them and we listened to all 10 of them and we picked the right one. Don't worry.
I won't take long. That's quite valuable.
It's not an accident that the voice fits her. I kind of want to go back to the missile. Okay, so these are the blood bead trees. Activate blood spring. Do I like the game so far? As it compared to other Souls games? I'm enjoying it. I'm not hating it or anything. I'm enjoying it. It's a bit weird, and it had a very, very slow start. Not helped by me doing my bullshit and saying thank you to people, but yeah. Imagine this being your first stream after being a fan of Joseph's Hurrah. It's someone's, man. It's someone's. Your blood has special properties that can activate dried up blood spring. Once revived, the blood spring will start producing blood beads again. These blood beads have the same composition as human blood. Revenants have been using them to quench their bloodthirst. All right, cool. Huh.
Could that really be?
So you give blood to get blood. The true blood. Magic missile. Storage. Okay, we're not gonna take anything out of there. Level up. Yeah, let's level up. How much do we need for level up? 897. Okay, can we use any of our lost shards? Let's use 897, right? Let's use 9. No, not 8 will do it. Now we're level 6. Thank you, A Fury of Owls, for the new sub with Prime. Thank you very much. Welcome to Prime Time, A Fury of Owls. Whenever I see Owls, or the name, I think of Shammy. All the time now. Thank you, Jebediah, for the 22-month resub as well. Thank you very much, Jebediah. Hope you're doing good. Welcome to the cringiest stream.
Could you fill me in on the details later?
Chat did this. This is all chat. Thank you, Jebediah. And thank you again, A Fury of Owls. What's the 16 out of 16 counter for? So there's abilities that use Ichor. You hold R2 and you can see them on the right. It's like a menu, and you can press triangle and you can increase the amount of power that you do, and they're active gifts. And you can get the 11 out of 16 back up to 16 out of 16 by hitting enemies, kind of like getting soul in Hollow Knight. You can also increase the 16 permanently, well, not permanently, semi-permanently, by using this weird ability on enemies. That's your clothes. Your clothes are your armor is a weapon too. And then it'll go up to like 17. Sometimes it goes up by more than one, but that goes away when you rest at a missile, so at a bonfire. So yeah, it's a bit strange. There's quite a few mechanics toward the game for how it works with getting around and everything, and your abilities, but not so much in moment-to-moment combat, it feels like to me. But we'll see.
It's open.
Queen Slayer Blade. Nice. Alright, so let's get rid of the pole arm for that, and let's see what the Queen Slayer Blade is like. A mass-produced single-edged sword supplied to soldiers by Operation Queen Slayer. Okay, so it's pretty much the same thing. No. Okay, so that one's faster than this one. So this is still a one-handed sword, though. Maybe it counts as a two-handed, even though it's bigger. All right, so what does this guy have? Queenslayer Blade has 205. So this one does more, but it's slower. I think I want to use the Queenslayer Blade. Okay, I don't think the stranger is with us. I think we're with him. He's ridiculously OP. He's hitting for thousands. Is he the last boss? So that was a parry that I just did there. This is how the parrying works in this game. But you can't... like, there's still... Even this one seems a little faster than the one I had before, but it still requires you to time it. Like, if you know the attack's coming, you can't just be like, okay, I parry. You have to time... Not the button press, but the dragon kind of lizard thing is coming together. At the end of it, that's what you have to time. Or maybe it's the flash, I don't know. We're getting a lot of the same weapon. Let's see if we can do it again. Whoa, what the f- Ooh. See, the arrow was way too early. Even though it happened at the same time they did the attack, it was way too early. Okay, so I'm finding that there's, like, moves that look like they have a lot of range kind of don't. That's really, like, close to you, much closer than it appears to be or it feels to be. Maybe it looks fine watching it instead of playing it, but that's how it feels to me. Miss something. That was well more hidden. Awake. Okay. Wow, we missed that, and we've been down there before, because that's where our footsteps are. Do we want to go back for it? I'm guessing it's not important, but I'm upset that I missed that. It's right there in the open, too. Try not to look at the mini-map too much, though. Purify Rotten Missile. Okay. Thank you, Senrahin, for the 19-month resub with the message, hey, 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 Senrahin. See, we started with Chiaki, and this is where we are now with this. Chiaki to this in less than a year. Pout Patrol.
Good. That's light from the surface.
Uh-oh. Is that Oliver?
Once someone is lost, they can never come back. Cast aside your doubt.
Do, do, do. Like, I can't remember his name now. At the end of Bloodborne. Because of his arms like that, he kind of looks like the guy at the end of Bloodborne. Fuck. And the Bloodstar Beast. Oh shit. Oh shit. We whiffed. What's he doing? What? Oliver, what happened to you, bro? Okay, so that doesn't have a follow-up unless I'm close, I guess. So when he does that run away? Okay. Oh, wrong one. I want regen inducer. Okay. Okay, we got him. All right. Greater loss dispersed. So I really like that if you dodge through attacks, wow.
She's all right.
Should have given her a tramp stamp. I really messed up there. I really like if you dodge through attacks, it looks like if you iframe through them, you get like a bonus to your focus thing. I really like that.
There are no exceptions.
A vestige. Best to stay away from those stones. Anyone who touches them is defiled, transformed into the lost. Don't listen to their whispers. Someone has to be sacrificed. Without blood beads, we won't make it.
Uh-oh. We're going hollow.
Once she's settled down, let's get out of here. I'll keep watch. Go and see if she's all right.
I kind of feel if I pick that up, I'm going to kill him. Let's talk to her first.
I hear a voice. I hear a voice.
I'll keep watching. Wait, what are you...
let go! It'll swallow you up!
It's all right. You can do it.
Our eyes went blue.
What the hell?
Okay, we're at the end of time. Where's Jasper?
Just this once. We won't make it if you take them.
All revenants must pay a levy of blood beads. There are no exceptions.
Do our wings change color depending on our mood? It's adorable.
Daddy! Mommy!
Someone has to be sacrificed. Without blood beads, we won't make it.
The few humans that remain are under Silver's control. Wandering revenants like us, forced to hunt for blood beads, will face death.
This is like the Kallok thing from Fallout 4. Yeah, I was just thinking that too.
Sacrificed for our survival.
Guess you reap what you sow, right? Well, that's all right. What's important is that at least one of us makes it.
Oh man, I'm feeling pretty emotional about the tutorial helper guy being dead. We've come so far together.
This is a memory echo. It's a place where lost re- This is a memory.
Okay.
This is a memory echo. It's a place where lost recollections still wander. Come, let's move on. If you use that stairway, I believe it should take us back to the world outside this memory.
Is this the past of one of the lost? No. There's no way.
Oh, the music just cuts out. All right.
What the hell was that?
It was a memory carved into that vestige. By the one who left it behind.
I didn't expect that I'd get dragged into it, too.
We both melted into you.
That's hot.
I can't believe this. What a power. Come with me. I know a spot where we can rest. I'm Louis. I'm researching blood beads.
How? What? How can you just take it off?
Nice to meet you.
What's the gas mask for? Is it a decorative gas mask? Is it just going to battle, pulling your gas mask? What is it for? What if I had not partnered up with him? What would have happened then? Berserker, code owner, Oliver Collins. Who the fuck is Oliver Collins? Features high strength and endurance. Its low Ichor stock can be offset with heavy armor. You acquired a new blood code. Okay. Merrick's here. Merrick, how do you feel about my waifu? Well, really, okay, chat's waifu. Chatmater.
The red mist showed up a short time after the queen was defeated. And when it did, it trapped everyone and everything inside, giving birth to the Society of Revenants ruled by Silva. The Jail of the Mist.
Silva, Silver, Vampires. Passed,
That was the name people gave to the world inside. The creatures trapped inside the miasma wander in a never-ending cycle of death and rebirth, always searching for blood beads to sustain them. Revenants need to have blood. Without it, they turn into those creatures we call the Lost. The Revenants who captured you were desperately searching for blood, terrified of losing themselves. It's a common fate these days. But ripples are beginning to form. You cleared the miasma and revitalized the blood spring.
It's gonna be funny the whole time. It's never gonna not be funny to me.
Where did you learn to do that? You've forgotten? Anything you do remember? That's unusual. Losing so much of your memory. I suppose it was the same for her. For now, just take it easy. Make yourself at home. You're looking a bit tired. We can talk again later.
Home base. Oh, there's more than you hear. There's a whole cast of characters. Alright, where's the waifu? Alright, there's the waifu.
It's warm here, isn't it? Everyone wants to know more about me, but I don't know the answer to any of their questions. All I can remember is that my name is Io, and that my place is by your side.
Io. Oh no.
My name. I have no idea what it means. I'm not sure. It was simply decided. One does what must be done. And for me, that is my mission. To stay at your side. I was wounded while I was searching for you. I am not a very capable fighter.
Oh, that's it? Okay. To lose the other one for exploration goal. I can feel the shadows are moving, and I can feel it getting cold. Cause in the darkness, a battle is brewing. The enemy is getting close tonight. There's nothing left to fear. If we can go back again, the future will start here. Is this Star Set? When are they gonna start growling? Let's leave that on. Never. Oh no, we can't listen to it. What? What? Oh, okay. Never mind. It's because of the direction. All right. Who are
you?
They're even bigger than hers.
Head into another pot of trouble. Well, it's none of my business, really. Anyway, I'm Coco, a merchant by trade. Stop by if you need anything.
Okay, I want to point out to everyone in chat right now, okay? I and by I mean chat, we put the booby slider up to the absolute top that it could go into the character creator, and the devs were like, no, you can't have bigger boobs. Let's call them what they are, tits. Then the mummy waifu, okay? Oh god, that's not gonna land, is it? That's gonna mummy like Egypt, not all fuck. Okay, I'm bailing on it. Okay. Then this one, and then we go over here, and they're even bigger. Like there's even more. All right, is there another waifu that has even bigger owies than her? I'm not looking at chat right. I'm actually a little embarrassed. I'm legitimately a little embarrassed right now. Okay, being in training. No, training. I want to look for boobs. No. Oh, okay. Just keep getting worse. Okay, what are we training? Finish training. Oh, God. Okay, it seems like that's it. Oh, the wings are so bright again. Code owner Mia Karnstein provides balance and stability in combat and features gifts useful during exploration. There's a lot of blood codes, damn. I can't believe I called her the mummy waifu and I didn't realize what the... Oh my god, I'm genuinely mad at myself. I should be more guarded. Go to hot spring? Alright, yeah, let's go. Yeah, why would the fuck... Let's go. I don't even care. Oh my god. Oh no. Oh no. They're here. Enter. Okay. Look back on past memories. Leave the hot spring. Awakening. Who's this? Thraldom. Okay, so these are just all of the cutscene viewer, okay. Whoa, you don't have a towel on? Okay, you do. It's just, you just can't see it. Who the fuck are you? Oh my god, adjust appearance. Oh, we can change everything. Nice. All right. Well, fucking perfect as always. And customization. Nope. Oh, here's the other ones I made, by the way. So, in case you got here late, here are the other ones. So, load customization. Oh, we can't. I can't show it. Ah, it sucks. Okay, I'll show them at the end of stream. So, I can only customize this one. I can't switch it to a different one. Okay. Add the trans stamp. Can I? I don't think I can. Makeup and everything's all on her face and everything, right? I don't think I can add the tramp stamp. It would have to be under accessories. So it'd have to be like that, and it would just, everyone just has to understand that it's kind of like a tattoo on her back. The tramp stamp. Make it as big as possible. Just sitting right here. Here's the tramp stamp. What color should it be? Should we make it glow? Glow pink like the wings? You exceed the maximum cost. Please address the accessory. Yeah, we can't do it. I'm sad. No body tattoos. That's kind of strange, don't you think? Okay. That's it for now. Were her hips swaying like that the whole time? Oh my god, the music. No, we're turning it off. For fuck's sake. Okay, what do you do?
Sorry, but I'm in the middle of taking inventory. Try me again later if you still need something.
Alright, I can't believe that she doesn't have the biggest boobs in the game, that there's someone bigger. I can't believe it. Oh, here's another, thing.
All revenants carry some secret with them. Don't do anything funny. I'll be keeping an eye on you until this talk with Louis settles down.
Nice to meet you. If Louis brought you here, there must be some reason, right? I'm Rin Murasame. I provide the back home support for all the explorers here. It's a pleasure.
Yeah, okay, Futaba.
I've got my own reasons for why I can't go into combat with you, but I'll provide your weaponry and maintain it for you. Anyway, relax and make yourself at home. I'm really sorry. Right now I'm in the middle of a periodic equipment inspection. Come and talk to me before you...
There you are. Revenant that Louis sees so much potential in. I'm Davis.
Mouths don't move. Definitely Dark Souls.
The government as part of the investigation into the depths. Just as a warning, try not to stir up any trouble. If you do, I won't be able to do my job, and well, you get it, right?
He looks almost as ridiculous as we do. Come on. Is this the same song?
Just so there's no confusion.
I can feel the shadows of moving.
Okay, so I want passive ones. Restores your generation power when your partner reaches... Okay, we don't want that one. Okay, so this is Berserker. Increases balance. I don't know what balance is. Is that our focus thing? I don't know what that is. Dragon Lunge. Increases the power of next attack. Alright, interesting. Okay, so I think we're good for now. Maybe we want to be upgrading to Berserker. Maybe we want to get rid of Fighter and then go over to Berserker. Features high strength and endurance. So like we don't these are the base jobs and we want to be moving to different jobs as we go. Maybe I don't know. Let's level up and see. Okay, so right now is it going to show us what we have? So right now weapon at one. Berserker is actually going to do less, but we have better base balance, we have slightly less stamina, slightly less HP, slightly less I-Core, weight limit is worse, so this is just really a good balance set, I guess, and our strength is better, but I guess this is for like big weapons, and we are using a small weapon right now. I thought our second weapon was a heavy weapon, maybe not. Okay, I'm gonna stick with what I have for now until I understand if there's anything better. And I like the Queen Slayer blade. That's the one I want to use. Okay, so this is training, so we can leave here. Alright. I don't know, I'm kind of feeling this game, chat. It definitely has more sense of style, and for everything apart from the combat, it's roped me in more than the Surge. It definitely has more flair, and it's more fun, but Surge 2 has better combat. Like, no doubt about it so far, but I haven't really explored these game systems that much, whereas I know Surge 2 systems more because I played Surge 1, so I don't know, I kind of feel like this has got me a little bit more in Surge 2 at the moment, which I'm surprised at, because Surge 2 is pretty competent from what I saw.
The ability to draw strength from experiencing memories, and the power to revitalize blood springs, both unprecedented.
Sorry, but could I get a sample of your blood? We might understand more if we analyzed it. It won't be much, just a small vial, so you won't need to worry about bloodthirst.
No.
It'll take a while to get the results. Take it easy in the room back there while you wait.
Oh, we don't have a choice? Interesting. Lie down. Alright, what's gonna happen here? Thank you, Clipping Jet, for the new Silver Prime. Sorry, that was almost 15 minutes ago. Sorry, Clipping Jet. We got into the home base here for a moment there. Thank you very much. Chat voted on this look, apparently. Oh, you missed the beginning, Merritt. You need to go watch the beginning of the stream. You'll enjoy it. Maybe not as much now. Thank you very much, Clipping Jet. Oh, we're just laying down. Okay, cool. All right, how long do we have to lay down for? You have underboob. You're only noticing now? Man, my taste is getting shittier by the minute, man. By the minute. All right, are we done now?
Sorry, but I'm in the...
I've done what I can to look into your talents. I've confirmed something surprising.
Oh, are we a waifu?
Revenants have blood types that differ from those of humans. These types greatly affect a revenant's abilities. However, your blood has no specific type. Or maybe more accurately, your type is broken.
Broken?
Your abilities, and the fact that you have no specific type, might be due to your being what we call a void type. You were able to gain another revenant's power through a vestige, right? That phenomenon is unique to void types.
Alright, is that it? So are all revenants vampires? Sorry, all revenants are vampires, but are all vampires revenants? Are we even vampires? I think they said vampires, I'm not sure. Thank you to Fidel Castro for the 12-month-3 sub. Welcome to the 1 year club, Fidel Castro. I love your name. Every single time makes me laugh. Thank you very much. Enjoy the 1 year chat icon. And same to Annie for Prez with 1 year club, 12 months. I'm regretting the 12 months I've been subbed just because of the underboob and cat ears. This is all chat, okay? Chat could have had 2B. You know what? Can we save it and we can show the other ones right now? All right, let's do it. All right, hold on. Let's save it. This is all chat, okay? But don't worry. I'm guessing it saved when we got here. Any unsaved progress will be lost. Well, shit. I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure it's fine. Here, let me show you. This menu is so automata. Wow. Yeah, it really is. Yeah.
Hey, can you hear me?
Who's Cruz?
Think back.
Wonder if she'll come back.
Search your memory for an image of yourself.
Okay, so look. So we had could have had waffles, all right? We made waffles, and by we I mean me. I made these characters at the beginning before the stream started, okay? Could have had waffles from Persona 5, all right? Could have had Junko from Danganronpa 1 only. Okay? Could have had Junko. I was really proud of the eyes. Those are full-on Junko eyes. Okay? Could have had 2B. Alright? Could have had 2B. Alright? But we did a vote, and it was these three or the mystery waifu, okay? And this is all chat saw of the mystery waifu, okay? That's all I showed them was that quick clip, all right? But no, chat wanted the mystery. Here they are again. 2B, Junko, and Joker. Thank you. believe it or not, I was actually a little worried that you guys wouldn't vote for the mystery waifu. I was a little worried. It wasn't even close.
The ability to draw strength from experiencing. Sorry, it won't.
Oh, okay, we have to get through the blood thing. Okay.
Take it easy in the room back there while you wait.
Oh, we don't go down there.
Rev, however, your ability, you were able to... Supposing you are a void type, there's a test I'd like to perform. Don't worry, I'll get something out of it. I'm going to give you some of my blood.
Whoa.
If my theory is correct, it should act as a medium. Give my power to you. Well, here goes.
I hope we bite him. Oh, we're not going to show it? Prometheus. Well-balanced for combat, but fragile. Its gifts bolster dodging and parrying. You've acquired a new blood code.
Did you go visit Murasame and Coco? They should be ready to do business now. Weapons and blood veils are vital parts of a Revenant's kit when exploring. You should take another look at them. If you've got materials, upgrade and transform them. Once you've got that settled, talk to me again, and we'll continue where we left off.
Alright, time to bite everyone.
It seems I can restore the blood code of a vestige's creator from elements left in the vestige. If you find any vestiges, please let me know. It could be a chance to grant you additional strength. It seems I can if it could.
Okay, so that gives us more attack damage, better balance, a little more stamina, a little more I-core, and much more defense too. Okay, but something about bolstering, dodging, and parrying? Okay, so let's go to the missile in a second. Let's see what they have.
Just about anything you could want.
I see that.
Even the lost are valuable customers if they bring the right coin. Let me know if you need anything.
Thank you, Cthulcifer, for the 12-month resub. A lot of one-year club today. Thank you very much. Welcome to one-year club, Cthulcifer. I always struggle to say your name. Almost a year, baby. Here's to another. Great to catch a stream again. No, you're there. 12 months in a row and total. Good job. Welcome. It's always good to mispronounce your name, Cthulcifer. It is a fun name to say, though. Thank you. Also, thank you to Exert Haddock. That's a weird name. I like it. Thank you. Welcome to Primetime, Exert Haddock.
Even the lost are even the.
Whoops. Exchange give valuables. All right, so we can give this to her, and that's it. And we get trading points. All right, receive items, trading points. We can get stamina booster, gift accelerator, stamp. Oh, we get a tramp stamp. Mercury chrome, a highly valuable mineral made from a special ore mixed with blood. Ask Murasame to use this to transform. I just pronounced that right, didn't I? What's happening to me? To use this to transform a weapon or blood veil and imbue it with obstructive properties, creating an equipment specialized in slowing enemies at the cost of decreased attack and gift properties.
If you want it, I got it.
All right, so you have Icor Concentrate, Anti-Venom, Anti-Stun, Icor Coagulant, Dagger, Vivifier, a drug that causes temporary dispersal, I don't know what that is, Chemical Light, Blood Marker, alright.
Come against.
All Revenants carry something.
Oh, good timing. I've got everything set up now. What do you need? I know it's a bother. But I'll need you to bring the necessary materials if you want to upgrade a weapon. There's a shortage of pretty much everything these days. Still, we're better off than most people.
I don't like you, Camel Toe Lolly. Go away. I don't like you. Alright, can we give you the same things? Alright, cool. So, I guess we have to find out what they like more than the other ones. like she'll like this more than someone else, I guess. And it's kind of like a little mini game. Okay, let's not do anything yet. Well, what can we get from her? Hephaestus Chrome, a highly valuable mineral. Okay, creating equipment specialized in stunning enemies at the cost of decreased attack and gift properties. Okay, I don't know if that's a blood veil or a blood guard thing or art, or if it's a just a weapon or something. I don't know. Transform equipment, transform weapon, transform blood veil.
Do you want to transform?
Okay. Blue Hound's Alleviation. All right, so is this a way that you can use whatever equipment you want, but and not have to? Oh, okay, yeah, it seems like it. So you can use whatever equipment you want, but turn it into something else. I don't know if it's still going to use the same thing though. Transform weapon.
Which weapon do you want to transform?
I want Queen Slayer Blade to transform into. Oh, all right. So this seems pretty in depth, actually. Okay, so even in Dark Souls, I don't like this shit. So if you do, congratulations. This game seems to have a lot of that stuff. I don't like this shit. So this is not for Joe, but it's cool that it's here, I guess.
Got something to sell?
What are we getting for this? 100. Whatever. Let's do it. Okay, buy Blood Veil. Alright, so you have... Ooh, you have different ones. Queen Slayer Claw. A Blood Veil used by forces of Operation Clear... In Operation Queen Slayer. Expensive. Number two... Why is two the same as one? Dark Hounds. Okay. Umber Hounds. I wish I could compare it. I wonder if it's... here somewhere. Oh, okay, so these are claws at the beginning. These are scorpions. These are dogs? I thought they were dragons. I guess they're dogs, hounds. And these are crown thorn things. Okay, so there are four different types. All right, okay. What about weapons? All right, so you only have two weapons. You have Queen Slayer Blade and Heavy Axe. All right.
Okay.
Just so there's no confusion, don't cause any trouble.
I wonder if we unlock new NPCs. Maybe the guy from Bayonetta shows up here. Oh, we can sit. Nice. Oh, let's play Gwent. Oh, man. We're so kawaii. We're so kawaii. Okay, so we can level up. Did I lose my level up when I restarted? Maybe that's what happened. Okay, so where's this Prometheus? All right, so Prometheus has Phantom Assault, Firestorm, Blade Dance, Flame Weapon, Deficient. You acquired Prometheus Vestige 1. We need Prometheus Vestige 2. Can be learned. Don't have enough haze. Passive. Fully restores stamina when you parry and attack. Oh, wow. That's really good. Holy shit. I want that. That's really good. And enhanced version of Blade Dance increases attack power when you dodge any attack. That's awesome, too. Wow. That's a lot of haze. Holy shit. Okay. So can we unlock this health boost so we can keep it? Oh, we've already unlocked it. Or maybe we haven't. Hold on. A lot of menu diving. Yeah, you're right. There is Prometheus. Okay, so we do this. And then can I equip these two? Nice, I can. Okay, so what else can I do? I can take Adrenaline with me. All right, so there's like a job system for sure. Reckless Abandon. I don't know what that does. Let's find out. A communal gift with Lewis increases attack and alters your evasive movements at the cost of damage reduction. And that's active. Okay. And we can learn these, but I don't think I'm going to use them, so... I don't know. Playing the game as my usual way seems like it's It's a waste. Temporarily increases attack power each time you damage an enemy with your weapon. Alright, let's get that one. That's fine. Let's get the other one too. Fuck it. Alright, there we go. You discovered a gift's latent potential. Once you become fully proficient with a gift, you will unlock the ability to inherit it. Alright, does that show up down here? Hey Joe, do you think a Last of Us 2 video is likely? I will be shocked if there isn't a Last of Us 2 video. Yeah. Shock, shock. So you can save and return the title screen right there. Okay, let's go. Let's continue.
You remember that scene we witnessed at the Vestige?
Do you pronounce Louis incorrectly because you're Britain and hate the French? Did he introduce himself as Louis or Louis? Because it can go either way, right?
Humans who survived under his protection. So revenants are left to rely on blood beads alone to slake their unending thirst.
Huh, I think maybe revenants drink these blood beads. He said Louis? Okay, I'll call him Louis for now, I'm sorry.
Nothing in this world lasts forever. The springs started to dry up, and so blood beads grew rarer and rarer. And the order Silva created by levying and distributing blood beads won't last much longer.
Sorry.
The world needs more blood beads. Only then can we strive for fairness instead of petty favoritism.
That's idealistic.
Why we've been exploring the Jail of the Mists. We're doing research to learn all we can about blood beads. But the miasma has been a real problem. It makes our thirst even worse, so our progress has stalled. Now, though, we have a glimmer of hope. Your power can clear the miasma. If you could help us... Well, you'd be drawn into a bitter conflict. Still, the truth is, we don't have a lot of hope without you. Will you join us? Thanks. So, it's a done deal?
Louis' friend.
Well then, from now on, you're one of us. Yakumo Shinonome. I'll be looking forward to seeing you in action.
Can't wait for you to betray us 10 hours from now.
Let's get right into it. Here's what's going on. We're studying blood beads and their springs. We want to know how and when blood springs appear, their cycles for producing beads, and the composition of the beads themselves. We've made a few discoveries. First of all, we found that there are tubes like capillaries running through the earth. We call them blood veins.
No! Oh, that hurt.
And so far as we can determine, every single blood spring is located on top of one of these blood veins.
Fuck.
Also, after comparing blood beads and blood veins, we now know that they are mostly comprised of the same substances. In other words, we can safely assume that blood springs always form along blood veins.
Great.
We think that means there must be a source somewhere. A kind of headwaters for the blood beads. Now that we have you around to clear the miasma,
are we on Earth?
Investigate the springs and follow the blood veins. And hopefully, find the source. Right? We want to check out the old city ruins first. Sorry for the rush, but we should head out as soon as you're ready.
Oh yeah, it's such a rush. Please slow down, game. Moving from missile to missile. You can move from one missile to another as long as they are activated. Note that it is not enough to have visited an area. The missile must be active or you cannot move to it. Okay, so you have to rest at a missile when you get there? Or activating a missile, does it automatically make it a... make you rest at it? I'm not sure. Personalizing your appearance. Okay, yep. Read note. Season Pass bonus, alternate Mia White. Talk to the figure in the underground storage to have your Season Pass NPC alternate Mia White accompany you as a partner. Okay, so I got this specifically for chat because I didn't know I was going to make fucking waifu Josephine at the time. But I got this specifically because I thought chat would appreciate it. Alternate Mia is available to accompany you as a partner. Okay, there we go. Switch partner. We haven't found her yet, though. Okay, so we're no longer partnered with her. We'll wait until we find Mia, and then we'll activate her alternative suit. I got this specifically for you guys. I even spoke about it in Discord. Thank you, Ralph Fox 100 Bits. Why are most vampires bad artists? Because they only like to draw blood. Nice. Nice. Thank you, Zelante, for the 15-month resub. Thank you very much, Zelante. Alright, do we talk to this guy, or do we talk to Louis, or do we go to the missile? I think we go to the missile, but let's talk to Louis just in case. Thank you very much, Zelante, for the 15-month resub. Exchange switch okay. Partner.
Is something up?
Stop partnering.
Is something up?
Okay, talk exchange. So we can give him valuables, too. What can we get from him? Prometheus Chrome. Huh. Enduring Crimson. Louis' trusty sidearm. It's red blaze engraved with a spell-like gift. We need 50? 50? Whoa, holy shit, dude. Okay, what's your name? Are you Mia? No, you're Coco or something, right? Yeah, Coco. I can't believe I remembered that. All right, and what's Futaba's name?
Hi.
Murasame. Okay.
Okay.
Partner, certain allies of the basic community partners you explore. You need to do. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, I'm not taking a partner. I don't want a partner. Home base training area. Okay. Who's in the training area? Thank you, Dashaway22, for the 6-month resub. Thank you very much, Dashaway. Hope you're enjoying the show. It's a special one today. There are some people who only joined the stream. Oh, we can't kill him. That only joined the stream after we got to the home base, and they just saw that for the first time, and they're like, what the fuck right now? Okay, outer crossroads or whatever. Yeah, companion's way too good. Yeah, I think so too. So unless we need it, we're going to go solo. Residents of the world. Activating missile allows other revenants and humans to enter areas that you've explored. Try to turn to a place you visited before and you just might encounter someone new. Alright, cool. Alright, we're not doing that.
Oh, you're exploring this area too? I'm a merchant of sorts. I wander around selling valuables as I explore. The miasma has gotten pretty thin here lately, eh? I thought it might be dangerous, but game all the same. I haven't seen a fellow explorer for a while, though. I think we were fated to meet. Take this map of the depths.
Thanks.
I'll be around here for a while. If you want to buy anything, let me know. As you travel around, you might find fragments. I collect stuff like that. A lot of rare, even in the depths nearby, the lost. So if you're headed there, remember to look at the map. Greeting.
Okay, so he likes things that are lost from the world.
I can give you valuables in exchange.
Flower seeds. Huh. Chocolate garlic flakes. What? Oh, what? What? Okay, so he would probably want a yellowed book then, right? Does it tell me how? Oh, it tells me in the bottom. I'm dumb. So I would get 200 haze for that. It tells me in the bottom, but he'd only give me 100. All right, but what do I need for?
Materials from the old world. I can give you valuables in exchange.
Did it show me for the other ones too? I don't know. Let's not do it. Accessing the depths, bringing maps to the depths to Davis at home base allows you to explore different parts of the depths. What is that? Is that like chalice dungeons? Alright, is this where we came from, or did we come from the other area? I don't remember. That looks familiar. Okay, that's where we... Oh, there's fucking footprints on the map. I'm so dumb sometimes. Whoa, was he moving? Or is that just kind of like... I'm so dumb sometimes. Alright, let's go this way and see. Vivi Fear. Whoa, frame rate. Okay, that's not the stream. That's the game. The stream might even be worse, actually. No, then there's no drop frames. Okay. Vivi Fear. Map, Den of the Dead. I don't know, chat. Is this more like Nier Automata than it is like Dark Souls? It's very Dark Souls in structure and everything, but I'm getting a much more Nier Automata feeling from it. It's like those two mixed together. It's a little cool. Only chat had chosen 2B, it would have been a much better fit. Chat really dropped the ball. How'd you unironically feel about this game? Was thinking about getting it, but the demo turned me away somewhat. I'm enjoying it so far. I'm not loving it, but I'm enjoying it.
Expectations exceeded. That settles it. You are absolutely vital to our operation. There are more blood springs ahead, but the miasma is blocking the way forward. Do you think you could clear it for us again?
So we need the gas masks for the miasma, and after we activate it, the miasma goes away. But... they're not able to do this, only we can.
To past expeditions.
All right.
Let's go have a look at them. The territory up ahead is teeming with the lost. Watch yourself.
Limbo of the Lost. Okay, so I want to go the other way and see what the other way is. Because I thought this was not the way, but it is. I don't notice any miasma. I don't notice it much either. Maybe it's just on the mini-map. I don't know. Huh. Is there fall damage? Should we find out? Wait. Okay. Oh, we're kicking a ladder down. Nice. Alright, now let's find out if there's fall damage. Oh! Wow, I really didn't think we were going to live there. All right, so now we're way back at the right at the beginning of the game. The very, very beginning. All right, and it said explore past areas to see if there's anyone new. So let's just do a quick run around and see. Maybe there's someone here. So that's the item we missed last time, right? So we found... Oh no, there's more items here. Did I just miss a shit ton of items here last time, or did they repopulate? I was trying to parry that. Whoa! Oh, we died! No! Knocked off. First death. Damn. Damn. Don't like that. Okay, so I think if you know what this means, then you'll know immediately what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna attack forward, and then I'm gonna turn around to face the camera and chain my attacks, and look what happens. She won't turn around fully. Yeah, I don't like that. This do? Why is it an inherently bad thing? It's not inherently bad, I just don't like it. It can be used to up the difficulty. Okay, so that's what a blood stain looks like. Too early again. Huh, alright. Not too late. I wanna get this down. There we go. Huh, we regain a lot of our ichor when we do that too. Okay, I don't think there's anything else down here. Let's continue the game. Although I'm curious to go give the guy the map and see if that's like Chalice Dungeons or not. We'll definitely do that before we end. So we have like 20, 30 minutes left of the stream. So we'll just keep playing until that's over. And then when we're about to end the stream, I will go and check that out, because I feel like some people are going to want to know if that's in the game or not. The few, the proud who enjoy the Chalice Dungeons. It's not lame, it's a feature. Yeah, if it's... You know, if that's something that you like, then, or it's done well for difficulty, then of course. But I don't really like it. But we'll see. It's still too early. Hey Joe, opinion on Sekiro? I really like it. It's probably my game of the year. It's between that or Baba Is You. Of course, until this came along. Now this is number one. But yeah, Sekiro's my game of the year so far. How's the game, Joe? It's pretty good. I'm enjoying it. Communal gifts are gifts that require the cooperation of a partner in exchange for the great power they grant. They exact a price from the users that when active and consume large amounts of ichor. The price and effects of communal gifts vary by partner. It also looks like that you can just play this whole game co-op with a friend. I have online turned off though, so I can't confirm that. Also, I don't have any friends, so I don't know if anyone who has played this game can confirm that for chat. That would be pretty good, but it seems like you can play it all on co-op the whole thing. Baba Is You is a puzzle game. Yeah, Baba Is You is a game that came out, I don't know, like 4 months ago? I've lost track of time. It came out on the Switch, and I played it on the Switch. And then I played it again on PC. And I have a script written about it, and it'll probably get a video. But the only other video I'm promising after Witcher is Sekiro. I'm not promising the Baba Is You video, but it'll probably happen. It's near certain. Whoa, that's fast. Holy shit, man. The real Dark Souls starts now. Huh. Ooh. There we go, finally. Alright. so fast. Okay, that time I went through and I feel like it shouldn't have. That felt a little too late. Okay, what's with the blue that's coming off of them when they die? Does that mean they dropped an item? Alright, let's go back to missile. Okay, didn't do well against those, but I was trying to parry. Should just use the bone. Can you shoot missiles? you can shoot magic, yeah, but not the missiles. Okay, so that's where the enemies were. What's down here? Prometheus Vestige Part A. Alright. Ooh, he heard us. Yeah, the sword range just seems really low to me. I felt like I was close enough there because the sword's gigantic, but it's not. I don't know if it's off or anything. I'm not saying that. It just feels wrong. Sunset sword. Sunset sword. Sunset sword is a warped queen slayer blade that has been corroded by miasma, and it has better physical but less scaling, better base, better crush. All right, I want to keep the one I have. Whoa, okay. How long does this last for? Is it on screen somewhere and I'm being blind? Is it the red? Is the red how long it lasts for? Because that's not very long. I guess it's a fair amount. Okay, that should have hit us there. I'll take it. Backstabs seem really abusable, Dark Souls 1 style. When I play Dark Souls 1 now, I try very hard not to use backstabs because they're so abusable. What's the blue bar? Blue bar is if... The only thing I've noticed so far is if you iframe through attacks, it seems like it's iframe, it builds up the blue bar and that makes it so you do more damage and you're less likely to be staggered and you're more likely to stagger the enemy. It's actually pretty cool, I like that a lot. But I don't know if there's any other way to fill it. Oh, you're a big boy. And you have friends. Going in the video. Wow. Wow. That's some Witcher 3 level hitbox detection there. Okay. There's not going to be a video. Fancy cologne, nice. All right, let's heal up. Why not? We have it. We're eating shit a lot. And we're not even in Persona 5. Pretty bad. Wish the combat was a little more weighty. Feels a little too light. Yeah, I get that. It's not too bad, though. It's not. I don't think it's as bad as it looks. Wow, okay. I didn't think that was gonna hit me. Okay, maybe I should stop doing backstabs. Those feel better than the weapons, I think. This feels like it has quite a bit of weight to it, and it's like, yeah, fuck you, got you, chunk, chunk. Lost shard.
I must be letting my image slip.
Hunter Vestige Part C. Who's talking? Oh, there's fan art? Hold on, 1 second. Why do I have 2 stream windows open? The vestiges talk. Oh, that's what it was. Okay. Well, someone got their wish. I don't think Merrick was here when we were talking about that. Merrick took on the evil. He drew the waifu. Wait, where did this save? Uh-oh. Where'd it go? It's missing. Hold on, I have to save it again to the fan art folder. Sorry for the delay. Where did this go? It went to... Yeah, it went to desktop fan art. Not showing up on my list here. It is there. That's weird. Okay, it's here now. All right, here we go. Whoops. So there's Solaire hanging out with our girl, all happy. World. Is he crying? Or is it from drinking through the helmet? Oh, man. You got the butterfly on the face, too. May contain trace amounts of hemoglobin. Nice. I can't believe you got the butterfly on the face, too. Fucking hell. Fucking hell. Yes, he's crying. He's crying. thanks for that, Merrick. Well, while we have fan art on the screen, let's put... Let's put the one from Celeste back on there too. Madeline fucking boom butterfly. What are you gonna do? If you come near me, I'm gonna hit you with this. What are you gonna do? Oh, it's just not gonna do anything. Okay, that was weird. Outplayed for sure. Why MJ-109? JRPGs do this sometimes, don't they? Or am I crazy? They put random numbers into items for no reason? I wonder what the rationale behind that is. Ooh, where'd you come from? I didn't see your special friend. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, uh-oh. Okay, legitimately died. Not good. Are you gonna keep playing this game? It's even funnier stream than Surge 2. I think we're probably gonna pick this over Surge 2. I don't know. I'd like to play Surge 2 as well. Maybe if there's nothing else coming out soon, we can go through both. But I don't know, how long is this game? Because if it's super long, we might not be able to play it all. Show the scorpion parry? Okay, cool. We'll do that after this. 1 second. Okay, so your different outfits have different monsters. So the one that we're wearing right now, as you've seen it before, these are hounds. They're not dragons. I can kind of see the hounds now. And they do this. And you guys saw the parry one already. And the first one that you start with is this one, which has just a claw. And this is the parry for that one, just a backhand, kind of cool. And then this one is the coolest one, I think, but unfortunately it hides our waifu, so we don't wear it. And this one has a scorpion tail. And that's it, and that's pretty cool. And it seems like the parry happens faster on this one, so here we go. Let's see if we can do a parry. Cool. Pretty good. I want to see the special animation though. There's an animation sometimes for when you get a parry. Nanny? Untitled Goose Game. We could probably play the Goose Game maybe tomorrow while we decide if we want to play this or Surge 2. I don't know. We don't have to play either of them. We can do none. Just play other games instead. Because I have a feeling this game is like at least 30 hours long, right? So that's 10 streams. That's too many streams. Whoops. So my criticism of the parry not working is that if it doesn't work, it looks like it should do damage, right? It doesn't look like we're gonna get the special animation, sorry chat. Oh, I thought it was done. There we go. Oh, it doesn't stun him? Wow. What are the good alternative Souls likes? Neo? Neo's arguably better than any of the Souls games. Arguably. Ashen is decent. Surge 1 is okay. Surge 2 seems better than Surge 1. Wow, that seemed late. Oh, we got it. Nice. Neo has bad level design in Diablo gear, though. I don't think Neo has bad level design. It has kind of bland level design, but I wouldn't call it bad. And the Diablo gear you can ignore until you get to the end game or the DLC, which is a flaw. Don't get me wrong. Like, I'm not excusing it, but yeah, you can ignore it for most of your time with it. Oh, that wasn't an attack. Shit. Okay, so here's what I'm doing. Here's the mistake I keep making. I keep overestimating how much reach our weapons have, and I keep underestimating how much reach the enemies have. Can I take this off now? I prefer the other one. There we go. Someone chat says they like that they had Diablo gear to it, adds another level to it. Yeah, if you can get into the end game and you can enjoy it, it seems like it's something else that you can have fun with, but I didn't really get into it that much. I just did the DLC, most of the DLC, without, you know, really under-geared and really under-leveled. It was pretty fucking difficult, actually. I didn't do the last level, though. Chat was getting really bored of it. Neo doesn't have enemy variety. It's not quite as bad as some people make it out to be. But, it does need more enemy variety. I've played games with way worse enemy variety than Neo. Sekiro's great? Yeah, Sekiro's really good. Thank you, Meishone. I think Meishone for the 5 month resub. Meishone. I think it's Meishone. Thank you very much for the 5 months. Will I ever say your name right? Feels like backstabs are the way to go. It just kills them faster. It's efficient. Not very good at this. We have quite a lot of souls, though. Feels like it's throwing the same enemy over and over and over again at you. And Undead Bird can get away with that because even at level appropriate gear, you can... Oh, what the fuck? Okay, cool. Something new. Even in level appropriate gear, you can mow through hollows real fast. But these ones are more substantial enemies. Okay, can I backstab you for massive damage? Nope. Oh yeah, I can. Nice. It just sounds like a normal person being tortured, not big monster. It's just... Ah! Too bad we didn't see any moves or animations. Yeah, I have no health, so I just, you know, see if I could cheese it and then I get past it. If I had some more health and we weren't short on time, I would have let it hit a couple times to try to parry it. I love our character so much.
What is it? You okay? Yo, Louis. You smell that?
Yeah. Human blood. An escapee.
Oh, are we the baddies?
Now, where did she run off to?
Hey, chumps! What the hell are you doing here?
None of your business.
Oh, really? Then tell me this.
It's Leon!
Why would scum like you have the sweet stink of a human on ya? The girl belongs to us. Put your paws on our property and your ash. That clear?
He just left. He's like, fuck the Bloodborne ladder, I'm just jumping down. Is the blood moving?
Fresh blood is some powerful stuff.
Damn, you call that fresh?
You're hanging in there.
Damn.
So, what's
the rollback eyes fit for a while?
We know it's just a matter of time until they find that missing human.
You know the plan.
Hell yeah. Let's hope she hasn't been devoured by horrors yet.
Magic missile. Okay, so we are out of time, chat, but like I said, when we get to time, I will go and see if there are chalice dungeons in this game. So let's see. So let's go back to home base and talk to the Sun Deer guy and see. Normal enemies are pretty bad in this game, but the bosses are pretty great. Hope you get to one before dropping it. We saw a boss earlier and it seemed alright.
Yes, this is a map of the depths. If you want to go to this location, tell me, and I'll guide you there.
Head to the depths.
I'll lead the way. Just tell me where we're going.
How can you lead if you don't know where we're going? All right, so Den of the Dead and Den of Darkness. Okay, this reeks of Chalice Dungeon, right?
It's unexplored territory from here on. Take care.
These are randomly generated dungeons that are different every single time. It seems like it. Depths, Den of Darkness. They're not random? Really? Okay, so these are just side content with just areas that you can just get loot and grind up experience, I guess? Hmm, okay, so I don't think I can show this because I don't have time to run through one, finish it, and then play it again. So maybe we'll do that next stream if we continue this, which I think we probably are. I don't know. I kind of want to play this game more than Surge 2. Sorry, Surge 2. Surge 2 is a big improvement of Surge 1, but I kind of want to do this one. They're not random, but it's Chalice Dungeons essentially. Okay. It isn't a boss if it doesn't have cleavage. Words to live by. Okay, so someone wants me to talk to another NPC. Which NPC do you want me to talk to? This one?
Hey, what's up?
Okay, switch partner.
Hi.
Okay, Futaba is just for shop. You want me to talk to the mummy? Okay.
What is it?
Prometheus Vestige 2, Hunter Vestige 3, Repair. Alright, so it doesn't seem like these are going to be used for anything else. So we get Savvy Evasion. What's Savvy Evasion? Increases the amount of focus gained from dodging attacks. Okay, cool. And then we get Death Parry, fully restores time when we parry. Oh, nice. Okay, so we need... we have A and we need B and we need C and we need D. Okay, I like this kind of progression tied to Exploration. That's neat. So you get different ones. Alright, so we can get Hunter Vestige 3. Ooh. Oh, you get a little story from it too. Nice.
Hey, hey, you. Give me all your blood.
Oh shit, it's Kevin.
You're gonna get hurt.
Look at me, being threatened by a little boy.
Ah, that's what we heard when we picked it up.
I'm not a little boy. Now hurry up and hand him over, lady.
Cause we're gonna shout it loud.
What did I say? You're just a little boy. Still, I have to admire your guts.
Go on, do what you want. I'll end up dead anyway if I don't bring those blood beads back.
Why? Is someone making you collect the beads for them?
What's it to you? You plan on giving alms to a poor, miserable thrall?
I'm not giving you anything. You'll have to make your own way in the world. What I can do is offer you a job. I need someone to scout out the place marked on this map. Think you can handle that?
The map led me to a fully laden blood spring, tucked neatly out of sight. It was so well hidden that I never could have found it on my own. She'd sent me to the Trove alone and unsupervised, so she couldn't very well complain when I took every last blood bead. After all, who am I to turn down an offer like that?
These sequences are considered cutscenes by the game, so you can always skip them. It's nice for repeat playthroughs. Oh, that's nice. That's a good feature that they did. So if I press start right now, oh, I can skip it. Nice. Well done, game. All right, I'm pretty impressed, to be honest. I mean, I'm not saying it's like 10 out of 10 or like, oh my god, best game ever. Nothing like that, but like, it's much better than I thought it was going to be for an anime titty game.
Talk about your unexpected trips down memory lane.
You're kinder than you look. You remember that?
Stop that. I do what I want to do, and that's all there is to it. Most revenants have lost the majority of their memories. I guess I'm something of an oddity in that respect. I've still got almost all of them. And the things I want to forget aren't going anywhere. Lucky me, right? Looks like you have the ability to restore people's memories. If you happen to find anything related to me, be sure to let me know, okay? I'll make it worth your while. There could be something out there that I've forgotten, and if that's the case, I want to see what it is. So the kid found the blood spring after all, hmm?
Aren't you mad at him? You planned to give them to him?
Maybe I did, and maybe I didn't.
How did you see it when... Okay, you know what? It's not worth... It's not worth thinking about. Have you fought a boss in Surge 2? Seems unfair to put it down without fighting at least one. I'm not putting it down. It's just, you know, of the two right now, having played both for a stream each, this is the more interesting game to me out of both of them. Even though Surge 2 probably has better combat. Okay, so someone wanted me to go down and see the season pass bonus, but we haven't met this character yet, so... I got this for chat. I'm not even kidding. I got this for chat. I looked it up and I was like, yeah, chat will really, really like the alternative Mia White. But we haven't met normal Mia White. So I don't really want to use it just yet because we haven't found her yet. Unless you don't, but I'm guessing, considering it's alternative, we must meet her at some point, right? Anyway, so let's end the stream in the hot spring. That was from your bits, IM999-1000. 100 bits to check it out. So we'll check it out when we find regular Mia. Maybe she comes into the hot spring. Okay, the tutorial said something about... oh god. Alright. No, okay, we almost went to whatchamacallit there. Whoa, butt shot. Alright, nice. What's the movie... Where she crosses her legs and she doesn't have underwear on. Basic Instinct. We almost went to Basic Instinct there. Alright, so here we are at the hot spring. Is it Basic Instinct? I don't know. You didn't know the movie name, but you knew that? Of course. Oh, this is like... Anyone's allowed in here? Who are you? Are you the guy that's gonna betray us? Yeah, for sure. Damn. Alright, that's it. thank you very much, everybody. Hope you enjoy my stupid joke at the beginning of the stream. I think we'll play this tomorrow, or we might play Untitled Goose Game. Maybe we'll play Untitled Goose Game and then switch over to this tomorrow. I don't know. I don't think Untitled Goose Game is worth a whole stream because it's quite short, I'm hearing, but it should be some fun. So maybe we'll do Goose Game. And I don't know. I kind of want to play this more than Search 2, so maybe we'll continue this for a little bit. I'll see if there's any other games that are coming out. There's also Noida. I'd like to play Noida again for one of them. But yeah. Anyway, the Q&As are every Friday now, so I'm going to start opening a Discord channel for Twitch subs to be able to ask it, but we're going to go finish the rest of the Patreon questions, and but every Friday... Whoa, what the fuck is her expression in the background there? Holy shit. Whoa. Okay, she's good now. Holy shit. I don't know what we're going to do tomorrow, like Goose Game, and then maybe we'll mess around in Goose Game. Maybe we'll play Goose Game, and then I'll try Katana Zero, because someone in chat's been wanting me to play that for a bit, or we'll play River City Girls, but I don't know. Like, if those are short games, I might as well just finish them. So, I don't know, Goose Game's kind of an awkward place. What about Al Seminium Files? That's going to be when the streams come back 5 hours a day, 5 streams a week. Or 5 hours a stream, five streams a week. After Witcher's done. I'm not going to play any big story games until that's done. But maybe we'll try Katana Zero. But we'll see. Goose Game is a 1 hour game. Yeah, that's what I heard. But I might get stuck at something, right? Because it's kind of a puzzle game, right? So I might get stuck at something. So it might be a 3 hour game for us after we go through everything. But we'll see. Anyway, thanks for stopping by. And I'll see you tomorrow. Hope you enjoyed Waifu Josephine. My disaster piece. Have a good rest of your day, chat.